We will solve problem 30 of chapter 27 at Sivama. We are given this a compartment where the walls do not allow exchange of heat. Delta Q is zero, and this also does not allow, this wall also does not allow exchange of heat. So the processes in this chamber and on this side will remain adiabatic. This side also adiabatic. What is given is, initially we pump in the gases in such a manner that the pressure here is P1, volume is equal on both the sides, which is V0.2 and V0.2. Total volume is V0, so volume is V0.2, and temperature is T1 here, pressure is P2 here, V0.2 is the volume and temperature is T2. Now what happens, the gases will try, both the sides will try to achieve an equilibrium in such a way that the pressure has to remain equal on both the sides. So let us assume that if I draw these chambers again, and let us assume that the wall which was initially at the center moves to this new location, this partition, which I show it like this, initially here, it goes to the new location. So the volume here becomes V1 and volume here becomes V2. Now the processes are adiabatic, so PV raised to power gamma is constant. This is important. Now let us apply this equation on both the sides. So initially it is P1 V0 upon 2 raised to power gamma, and what is the pressure on this side? Pressure on both the sides will become equal at the equilibrium. Only then this partition will stop moving, when the pressure on both the sides, because the forces on both the sides has to remain equal. So pressure, let pressure be P, and the volume V1 be V1 raised to power gamma. And similarly for the other side, P2 V0 upon 2 raised to power gamma is equal to final pressure into final volume, which is V2 raised to power gamma. Now V1 plus V2 is V0. So for this, take 1 upon gamma times on both the sides. So you get P1, 1 upon gamma, this is 1 upon gamma, V0 upon 2 is equal to P, 1 upon gamma V1, and this side becomes P2, 1 upon gamma, V0 upon 2 is equal to P, 1 upon gamma into V2. Now you add both these sides, you get V0 upon 2, P1 1 upon gamma plus P2 1 upon gamma is equal to P1 upon gamma, this is 1 upon gamma, V1 plus V2. This is given as Cp upon Cv in the problem. The gases are same on both the sides. So this becomes V0. So we solve it, it becomes P1 1 upon gamma plus P2 1 upon gamma upon 2 is equal to P1 raised per gamma. Because this is V0, that gets cancelled, so we get this as the final relationship. Now P1 1 upon gamma plus P2 1 upon gamma, keep it as say x. So P1 upon gamma becomes x upon 2, or P becomes x upon 2 raised to power gamma. So this is the answer as far as the pressure is concerned. Similarly, you can find the volume. Use any one of this equation. Use the first one. Use this equation. So we get P1 V0 upon 2 raised to power gamma is equal to P is how much? Is x upon 2 raised to power gamma, and b1 raised to power gamma. So just take 1 upon gamma on both the sides, so it becomes p1 1 upon gamma b0 upon 2 is equal to x upon 2 into v1. So it v1 becomes p1 1 upon gamma b0 upon x. Similarly, v2 will become p2 1 upon gamma v0 upon x, and x we know was p1 1 upon gamma plus p2 1 upon gamma. Sorry, it is gamma. So this solves the problem.